Okay, this is the final exam review. We'll start with gastrointestinal. Antacids, calcium carbonate, and magnesium hydroxide. Again, that's the stomach, so you got to remember that there's acid. It has to be acid if you're going to use an antacid, and it's about 1 to 3 hours after they take it. Then the H2 blockers end with tidine, T-I-D-I-N-E. Proton pump inhibitors end with prazole. Then we'll go down to diarrhea and constipation, so bismuth subsalicylate and loperamide, then docusate sodium and polyethylene glycol for constipation. Then we have nausea and vomiting, so citron for nausea, which is a 5-HT3 antagonist, then promethazine for vomiting, then IBS versus IBD, irritable bowel disease, and with infliximab for infliximab or Remicade. Which is a remission aid. Musculoskeletal, you go out of the pain cave, so remember this is prostaglandins, the P. Then aspirin, ibuprofen, naproxen, the caffeine with aspirin and acetaminophen for headache. The acetaminophen by itself is a non-narcotic analgesic. Meloxicam is a very long acting non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. Then celecoxib is the COX-2 inhibitor. The C2s, morphine, fentanyl, hydrocodone with acetaminophen, oxycodone with acetaminophen, C3, acetaminophen with codeine, C4, tramadol. The antagonist is naloxone. Then we go from head to toe here with a little guy here. And for the headache, we have the triptans, which are the 5-HT1 antagonists. We'll just zoom in on that. And then we're going to go joint, bone, muscle. So joint is methotrexate with Tuscept and then Nercept as two of the other DMARDs for Abatacept and Etanercept. Then in the bone for osteoporosis, we have Dronate, the stem for bisphosphonates. And then for muscle, cyclobenzaprine, you can benz. And then diazepam, which is actually a benzodiazepine. And then for gout, allopurinol, and the Zostat from Febuxostat. Okay. Respiratory, we remember that H1 versus H2, and H1 antihistamine is for the nose with our antihistamine snowman, H2 is for the stomach. Okay. So diphenhydramine is the first generation, which that's a brain, and so we cross the blood-brain barrier, and that's why it makes you sleepy. And then we have cetirizine and loratadine as two of our second generations. So that's a first and a second. I mean, my handwriting's not great. That's a nose on the left, and then pseudoephedrine, phenylephrine, oxymetazolin, an acute decongestant, versus triamcinolone, which is a prophylactic for allergic rhinitis. You could also use a fluticasone or Flonase or mometasone, something like that. So we'll put the bifurcation in the bronchi, and you just kind of put a C sideways to make cough. With guaifenesin with dextromethorphan, guaifenesin with codeine. Then we've got a little campfire for our prednisone and methylprednisolone. And then you can think of fluticasone too, but think of the fire or the flame for inflammation. Sometimes we have inflammation and bronchoconstriction and asthma. So we've got our boa constrictor with our inflammation campfire. So you might see, you know, formoterol with budesonide, or you might see, I'm blanking on it, but it's going to be fluticasone with salmeterol. I'm doing this all from memory. And then albuterol is just when the bronchoconstriction's alone. You could have put salmeterol there too, or salmeterol, however you say it. And then when you have the bronchoconstriction, you can also use the Tyrol albuterol with the ipratropium. So I put a little tropical tree there. So ipratropium, and remember tiotropium is the long-acting one. And then there's a couple more, M-O-R-E, respiratory drugs. So montelukast. Leukast is a leukotriene inhibitor, omalizumab for allergy. That's just respiratory to remember. And then epi for anaphylaxis. Okay. Immune, we start with the amoxicillin and the amoxicillin with clavulanate. We have a cell and then walls to remind us that it affects the cell wall. First, third, and fourth generation cephalosporins. First, Ceph, C-E-P-H. Third, Ceph, Tri, T-R-I, to remember it's third. And then Cefepime, which was the maximum generation at one time, Maxepime, but we know there's a fifth now. The van getting out of the prison, so vancomycin, it's a glycopeptide. Okay. And if you think of four cycles coming out of that van, then you have tetracycline, doxycycline and minocycline are two of those. And then you have throw mice versus macrolide. So I thought mice are small, macro is big. So three throw, so you've got azithromycin, clarithromycin, erythromycin, all three of those. Clindamycin and lincosamide, so there's some similarities there, the lin and the C, and then lincosamide. And then the zolid from linezolid, which is an oxazolidinone antibiotic. The aminoglycosides ending with casein or gentamicin. I can't really use that stem with gentamicin. UTIs, sulfa and prim for the folate. Dihydrofolate reductase inhibitors. And then the FL from floxacin with the FL from fluoroquinolone. And then for peptic ulcer disease, nidazole from metronidazole with the nitroimidazole. Going up to TB, so we have RIPE, rifampin, isoniazid, pyrazinamide, ethambutol. Those are our big four. Then antifungal, so the amphotericin B from the A, the fluconazole from the F, and the nystatin from N. Some of the antivirals, non-HIV antivirals, amivir influenza, cyclovir for HSV and VZV, and then visumab for RSV as those stems. Okay. Outside the cell, if you're talking about HIV trying to come into a healthy cell, you've got infuvertide, so you can think FU from fusion and VIR for antiviral, and then the Virox CCR5 antagonist. But then inside the cell, we have the what I guess you would call the ACEs or the enzymes that they affect, the NNRTIs, the virins and cytobine, and then the NRTI, the tenofovir, the integrase, and so that tegravir and tigrase are very similar, and then protease inhibitor, navir, so those stems to help you with immune. Going on to neuro with mental health, think cane and pain, so benzocaine or lidocaine. I was thinking of Pez melt in bed. So you've got the PM from Tylenol PM, which is really diphenhydramine with acetaminophen, the clone, esopiclone, and then the Zolpidem, and then Remeltion, so it melts. So the Pez, P-E-Z, melts in bed. And then you come out of the stairs, so you go down the stairs as you feel better from antidepressants. And the first stair is SSRIs, the escitalopram, citalopram, sertraline, fluoxetine, paroxetine, both of the doxetine stem, but we could be careful because there's the SNRI duloxetine and then venlafaxine. The tricyclic antidepressant, remember the tri-TRI from amitriptyline, the MAOI isocarboxazid, isocarb boxes, so you're really sad because you're carving boxes. Bupropion and varenicline, both to help you stop smoking, but bupropion was also an antidepressant, so that's kind of the link. And then if you smoke, maybe you have some anxiety. So the azapam and azolam. So in anxiety, you kind of have that Z sound that might help you. I remember that the benzos are the azapam, azolam. The ADHD, so dexmethylphenidate, methylphenidate. The non-stimulant was atomoxetine. Again, watch out for that oxetine stem. And then the mood stabilizer, Li+, which is lithium. Okay. So coming up here to schizophrenia, we have the low potency typical, which is also first generation chlorpromazine, the high potency typical, which is haloperidol. Then we have something like risperidone, which is second generation, quetiapine, which is also second generation, both of those causing those metabolic effects versus the EPS. The traditional antiepileptics, so I couldn't really think of anything here, but carbamazepine, divalproex, and phenytoin. The newer ones are pregabalin and gabapentin, two of them, so they have that GAB in the middle stem. Parkinson's, levodopa, carbidopa, and selegiline. And then Alzheimer's, donepezil, and memantine, the MEM from memory for that. And then the motion sickness, scopolamine. Okay. So cardio, we use the Nephron. So we start on the left with the osmotic diuretic osmotrol, then we go up the loop, ascending loop of Henle with furosemide, then to the distal convoluted tubule with hydrochlorothiazide, Spironolactone, triamterene are in the collecting duct, and then potassium, because they're potassium sparing, we can also use potassium as a supplement for hydrochlorothiazide and furosemide. Alpha-1 blocker, like doxazosin. Alpha-2 is clonidine. You want to know the difference between first, second, and third generation beta-1 blocker or beta blocker. So beta-1, beta-2 would be propranolol, which is first generation. Second would be beta-1, which is metoprolol. It's specific. And then again, we have the non-specific carvedilol, but it also has a vasodilatory effect, so the DIL for vasodilator. The renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, all of these are vasodilators as we go from the RAAS to the calcium channel blockers to nitro. So we start with the zymogen, which is angiotensinogen. Then we see use renin or renin to get us to angiotensin 1. The ACE inhibitors have the pril stem, so lisinopril, things like that. And then we block angiotensin 2 at the receptor. Angiotensin 2 receptor blocker ends with sartan, like valsartan. Okay. The CCBs, so these actually, the brand names are a lot easier to make it remember. So Cartizem and Kalin both start with C, but the Tiazem and Pamil stem from Diltiazem and Verapamil, these are both non-dihydropyridines. These are the ones that affect the heart and vasodilate, so you can think of bradycardia there, CCB. And then the dip in blood pressure from the regular dipines like amlodipine, flodipine, and all of those, DIPINE. Okay. Nitro is the vasodilator. Didn't really know where to go with that. Most people know that. The LDL, so HMG-CoA reductase, usually end in VASTATIN, so be careful. Nystatin, the antifungal, is not an HMG-CoA. And then the triglycerides, so fibric acid derivatives, the fibrate stem. Okay. The anticoagulants, warfarin, heparin, enoxaparin, dabigatran, all of these have their own stems. The antiplatelets, aspirin, and then something like clopidogrel, which is Plavix. And then the cardiac glycoside, digoxin, and the anticholinergic atropine for emergencies. Okay. Then we'll go to endocrine and some kind of miscellaneous ones. So with the insulin, we usually do it in order of how long it's going to, or how quickly it'll work. So like a Humalog would work really quickly. Then the Humulin R, Humulin N, and then Lantus, the very long-acting one. PO diabetic medications, something like metformin. The gliptins, or something like glipizide, the sulfonylurea. Then glucagon is for when the glucose is gone. Levothyroxine, when you have too little thyroid hormone, you have to replace it. And then PTU, when the thyroid hormone is up, you kind of just put a little P after that U, and then that'll help decrease it. Testosterone, the male sex hormones are usually going to have some kind of steroid, so STER is the stem. Estrogen is ESTR, and GEST, progestin. Okay. The OAB, overactive bladder, so you can think you got to get your butt in the toilet for oxybutynin. Fenicin, try to fence in the urine. And then tolteridine, didn't know anywhere to go with that one. You have urinary retention, so bethanacol is the one. And by keeping them next to each other, it's helpful, and you may be able to picture it in your brain. Then the ED drugs, like the vardenafil or sildenafil, which is Viagra, that afil stem. And then the alpha blockers, which don't really have that vasodilatory effect, that are specifically for BPH, the tamsulosin and alfuzosin. And then the 5-alpha reductase inhibitor, finasteride, dutasteride, those both for BPH as well.